9 minus omega square, 9 minus omega cube. So if from these terms we keep on putting the value of x as 9, so we'll get the terms 9 minus omega, 9 minus omega square, 9 minus omega cube, and till 9 minus omega cube and n minus 1. Hello everyone, स्वागत है आपका मेरे चैनल नरेंद्र मोहन चौधरी के कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर पार्ट 7 में और उम्मीद करते हैं कि आपको ये वीडियो पसंद आएगी. In this video, we're going to take some more of the questions from the concept of complex number. So let's take a look at some more questions. The first question of the video says, if 1, omega, omega square, omega cube till omega to the power n minus 1 are the nth roots of unity, then the value of the term 9 minus omega into 9 minus omega square into 9 minus omega cube till 9 minus omega to the power n minus 1 will be, we are given 4 options for this, n 0, 9 to the power n minus 1 upon 8, 9 to the power n plus 1 by 8. Okay, so how to deal with this question? We are given that these are the nth roots of unity. So x to the power n minus 1 can be given by x minus 1 into x minus omega into x minus omega square till x minus omega to the power n minus 1. So we want the terms n 9 minus omega, 9 minus omega square, 9 minus omega cube. So if from these terms we keep on putting the value of x as 9, so we'll get the terms 9 minus omega, 9 minus omega square, 9 minus omega cube, and till 9 minus omega to the power n minus 1. So after feeding the value of x equal to 9, we get 9 to the power n minus 1 upon 8, that is given by 9 minus omega into 9 minus omega square till 9 minus omega to the power n minus 1. So this matches with the option C of our question. So the correct response is option C, 9 to the power n minus 1 upon 8. Now let's take a look at the next question. If 1, omega, omega square are the 3 cube roots of unity, then for alpha, beta, gamma, sigma belonging to real, the expression alpha plus beta omega plus gamma omega square plus sigma omega square divided by beta plus alpha omega square plus gamma omega plus sigma omega equals, we are given 4 options for this, 0.1, 1, omega and omega minus 1. First of all, then let's check the numerator out. The numerator equals alpha plus beta omega plus gamma omega square plus sigma omega square, and the denominator equals beta plus alpha omega square plus gamma omega plus sigma omega. Here in this case, we can write beta into 1 as beta into omega cube, and gamma omega and sigma omega as gamma omega to the power 4 and sigma omega to the power 4 as a value of omega to the power 3 equal to 1. Okay, so after this, we can, after writing these expressions, we can divide these two, and the only term which is remaining in the denominator is omega square. So it rumbles down to 1 upon omega square. Again, we can write 1 as omega cube. So the final answer comes out to be omega. So this matches with the option C of our question. So the correct response for this question is option C, omega. Now let's look at the next question. If n is a positive integer but not a multiple of 3 and the value of z is equals to minus 1 plus root 3 iota, then the value of that expression z to the power 2n plus 2 to the power n z to the power n plus 2 to the power 2n equals, we are given 4 options for this question, 0, minus 1, 1 and 3 into 2 to the power n. So after looking at this expression, we can derive that this is similar to the equation a square plus ab plus b square, and this term can be derived from the expression a cube minus b cube upon a minus b or b cube minus a cube upon b minus a. Okay, so we can write this z to the power 2n plus 2 to the power n z to the power n plus 2 to the power 2n as z to the power 3n minus 2 into 3 to the power 2 to the power 3n upon z to the power n minus 2 to the power n. Okay, so we are given that the value of z is equals to minus 1 plus root 3 iota. So by putting the value of z as minus 1 plus root 3 iota, we can also formulate it as mod z into e to the power iota theta, where theta is its principal argument. So we can write this as 2 into e to the power iota 2 pi by 3. So when we convert this of the form z to the power 3n, it converts into z to the power 3, that is 8 into e to the power iota 2 pi. So z to the power 3n becomes 8 to the power n. So the numerator of this term becomes equal to 8 to the power n minus 8 to the power n, that is equal to 0. So therefore, as the expression will be given by numerator but denominator, and the value of numerator becomes 0. So therefore, this becomes equal to 0. We can also check that denominator is not equal to 0 as n is not a multiple of 3. Therefore, the correct response for this question is option A, 0. Now let's take a look at the last question of the video. If 3 by 2 plus iota root 3 by 2 to the power 50 is equals to 3 to the power 25 into x minus iota y, where x and y are real, then the ordered pair x comma y is given by, we are given 4 options again for this question, 0 comma 3, 1 by 2 comma minus root 3 by 2, minus 1 by 2 comma minus root 3 by 2, and 0 comma minus 3. Again, we are given the value of complex number as 3 plus 3 by 2 plus iota root 3 by 2. So converting z as the form of mod z into e to the power iota theta, where theta is the principal argument. So we can write 3 by 2 plus root 3 by 2 iota as root 3 times, this is the modulus of the complex number, multiplied by e to the power iota pi by 6, where pi by 6 is the principal argument. So z to the power 50 can be written as root 3 to the power 50 into e to the power iota pi by 6 into 50. So that rumbles out to be 3 to the power 25 into e to the power iota 25 pi by 3. We already know that 25 pi by 3, e to the power iota 25 pi by 3 can be written as 3 to the power 25 e to the power iota pi by 3, as the difference between 25 pi by 3 and pi by 3 is of 8 pi, where 8 pi is a multiple of 2 pi. Therefore, we can write it as 3 to the power 25 into 1 by 2 plus root 3 by 2 iota. So, comparing this 3 to the power 25 into 1 by 2 plus root 3 by 2 iota with 3 to the power 25 x minus iota y, we can compare the values of x and y with this. So, the ordered pair x comma y comes out to be equal to 1 by 2 comma minus root 3 by 2. So, this matches with the option B of the question. So, the correct response for this question is option B. Half comma minus root 3 by 2. अगर आपको ये वीडियो पसंद आई तो कीजिए लाइक, कमेंट, शेयर और सब्सक्राइब. कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर पार्ट 8 विल बी आउट वेरी सून. टिल देन स्टे ट्यून्ड.